Hello students, so next we will consider the anatomy of monocot leaf. So monocot leaf, its example is maize. So maize is the example of monocot leaf. Now this leaf is also called isobilateral leaf. Monocot leaf is also called isobilateral leaf. It is called isobilateral leaf because the both surfaces of leaf, that is upper and lower surface, they are same, right? The upper and lower surface of this leaf is identical or same. That's why it is called isobilateral leaf. And here the stomata are equally distributed on upper and lower epidermis, right? So first we shall consider the epidermis. So epidermis of monocot leaf, it is single layered, composed of parenchyma cells. Now this epidermis has two surfaces. Epidermis has two surfaces. They are called upper surface and lower surface, or upper epidermis and lower epidermis. Now both upper and lower epidermis are single layer. So they are composed of single layer of parenchyma cells. Now both upper and lower epidermis, they are identical. That's why the leaf is called isobilateral leaf. And here on the epidermis, there are stomata. So stomata are equally distributed on upper and lower epidermis, right? Now these stomata are involved in transpiration. Then between the upper and lower epidermis, there is a tissue called, can you tell which tissue? So between upper and lower epidermis, there is a tissue called mesophyll, right? So this is the main tissue of leaf, it is called mesophyll. And this mesophyll tissue, it is not differentiated, it is undifferentiated, means mesophyll tissue of monocot leaf is not classified as palisade and spongy. So you don't find palisade and spongy cells here, right? So you can observe all one type of cells only, right? Here you find only one type of cells. So mesophyll is composed of one type of cells. That's why we say mesophyll is not differentiated into palisade and spongy cells. Next, in the veins, right, in the veins of monocot leaf, we can observe vascular bundles. Right, vascular bundles, again they are found in the veins of the monocot leaf. Now if you observe the vascular bundles here, right, which are located inside the veins. So each vascular bundle, it is called conjoint. The vascular bundle is called conjoint because, again, the reason is same. Phloem and xylem, they are present in the same bundle and they lie in the same radius. So such vascular bundles are called conjoint. Now here phloem is on the lower side, xylem is on the upper side. Fine. So then one more important point here is the bulliform cells. Sometimes you may expect the question, what are bulliform cells? So these are large colorless cells located in the upper epidermis. So bulliform cells are large, they are colorless, located in the upper epidermis. So such cells are called bulliform cells. Now these bulliform cells, when they lose water, right, when water is lost from the bulliform cells, what happens? The leaf exhibits कर्लिंग और रोलिंग. सो द लीफ इट रोल्स और इट कर्ल्स राइट एंड दिस प्रिवेंट्स ट्रांसपिरेशन और लॉस ऑफ वाटर. It prevents the water loss or it prevents transpiration, right? So that is the function of bulliform cells. So bulliform cells, when they lose water, they cause curling or rolling of leaf. So the leaf rolls, right? It folds and it helps to prevent the loss of water, right? So that is the function of bulliform cells. So that is about the anatomy of a monocot leaf. So we shall revise this once again in brief. So the example of monocot leaf is maize. Most of the grasses, they are monocots. So here we have taken the example of maize. Monocot leaf is called isobilateral leaf because both upper and lower epidermis are same. There is no much difference. Both upper and lower epidermis have stomata which are equally distributed, right? On the upper epidermis, there are large colorless cells called bulliform cells. These bulliform cells help to prevent transpiration, right? When they lose water. When bulliform cells lose water, they cause rolling of leaf or curling of leaf that helps to prevent transpiration or loss of water. Between upper and lower epidermis, the tissue of the leaf, it is called mesophyll. This mesophyll is not differentiated into palisade and spongy. So you find one type of cells in the mesophyll. Now mesophyll cells, they are all modified parenchyma cells. They are green colored cells because they contain chloroplast. Chloroplast contains chlorophyll and this chlorophyll is involved in photosynthesis. Right? So food is synthesized in the leaves of plants. Then after mesophyll, the next part is the vascular bundles. So vascular bundles of leaf are located in the veins, right? Midrib has large vascular bundles. Peripheral veins have small vascular bundles. Now the vascular bundles here, they are conjoined. They are called conjoined because phloem and xylem are present in the same bundle and they lie in the same radius. In the vascular bundle, phloem is on the lower side, xylem is on the upper side. So that is about the anatomy of a monocot leaf. So you may expect this as a 5-mark question. Explain the anatomy of monocot leaf or explain or draw a label diagram of section of monocot leaf. So either you may expect explanation or you may expect a diagram or you may expect some 1-mark questions in this concept. So with this we shall conclude and we shall continue in the next video. Thank you. Hello students. So next, we will consider the anatomy of leaf. So in that, we shall consider the anatomy of dicot leaf. So for dicot leaf, the example again is sunflower. So this section of sunflower leaf or dicot leaf, it appears like this. Now this dicot leaf, it is also called dorsiventral leaf. It is called dorsiventral leaf because the two surfaces of the leaf, the upper and lower surface, they are distinct, means they are dissimilar. So it is called dorsiventral leaf, right? So in the section, you can observe the epidermis. So the epidermis in dicot leaf, it is having upper and lower surfaces. So epidermis has upper surface and lower surface. So here you can see, this is the upper surface and this is the lower surface, or upper epidermis and lower epidermis. So epidermis, here it is upper epidermis and lower epidermis. Upper and lower epidermis are not same, they are distinct, right? They are not same, they are distinct. Means clear cut differentiation occurs, right? Upper and lower epidermis are totally different. That's why it is called dorsiventral leaf. The stomata, which are found on the epidermis, their number is not same. So more number of stomata are present on lower epidermis. So the number of stomata are more on lower epidermis and they are less on the upper epidermis. And you know the function of stomata. So stomata is involved in transpiration, that is loss of water through leaves. Then below the upper epidermis, right, below the upper epidermis and above the lower epidermis, or we can say between upper and lower epidermis, there is a tissue. That tissue is called So you can see here, this is the tissue between upper and lower epidermis. So this tissue of the leaf, it is called mesophyll. So mesophyll is the parenchymatous tissue that is present between upper and lower epidermis. Now this tissue, it is classified into two types. So mesophyll tissue of leaf, it is classified as palisade and spongy. So we can call it as palisade parenchyma cells and spongy parenchyma cells. Palisade cells, they are present near the upper epidermis. Spongy cells, they are present near the lower epidermis. Now the shape of these two cells is slightly different. They are elongated. Palisade cells are elongated, means their shape is like this. They are elongated. Spongy cells, they are oval, means like this. So these elongated cells are palisade, these oval cells, they are spongy. So palisade and spongy. Palisade cells are present below the upper epidermis or near the upper epidermis. Spongy cells are present below the palisade cells or near the lower epidermis. So these palisade and spongy cells, they are modified parenchyma cells. And these cells, they contain chloroplast. These cells contain chloroplast. So these cells are green, right? These cells are green because of chloroplast. And this chloroplast contains a green pigment that is called chlorophyll. Then the vascular bundles here. So vascular bundles in the leaf, where they are located. So these vascular bundles, they are located in the veins. So vascular bundles in leaf are located in the veins. So you might have seen a leaf. A leaf surface has lines. So I will draw it here. So imagine this as a leaf. So it has lines like this. So these lines, they are called veins. So the central line is the mid vein, and these branches, they are called veins. So midvein and veins. So these veins contain the vascular bundles. Now this is the central part of the leaf, or this is the central part of the leaf, right? And this is the peripheral part. So peripheral part and the central part. Peripheral part of the leaf has smaller veins, and these veins contain vascular bundles. The central part of the leaf has a larger vein that is called midvein or midrib. So this midvein or midrib is large. So it has a large vascular bundle in the center. Now if you consider the vascular bundle, it is having phloem on the lower side, xylem on the upper side. So phloem, xylem, they are present in the same vascular bundle and they lie in the same radius, right? Phloem and xylem, they are present in the same radius. That's why the vascular bundles in the leaf, that is dicot leaf, they are conjoined. So you can find conjoined vascular bundles. So understood the meaning of conjoined vascular bundles? So here phloem and xylem is present in the same bundle and they lie in the same radius, right? One below the other. Then if you consider the midrib region, below the epidermis or below the upper epidermis, you can observe a small part that's called hypodermis, where you find collenchyma cells. So collenchyma cells are present in the midrib region below the epidermis, right? So that is about the anatomy of a dicot leaf. So we shall revise this in brief. So in the section of dicot leaf, right, or in the section of a sunflower leaf, you can observe upper and lower epidermis, right? Upper epidermis and lower epidermis. Upper surface is normally called the dorsal surface. Lower surface is called ventral surface. So dorsal and ventral surfaces are not same. So leaf is called dorsiventral leaf. Now the upper and lower epidermis, they are having pores which are called stomata. More number of stomata are present on the lower epidermis, less stomata are present on the upper epidermis, and these stomata are involved in transpiration. Then the tissue present between upper and lower epidermis, the tissue of leaf between upper and lower epidermis, it is called mesophyll or mesophyll tissue. Now this mesophyll tissue is classified into two types of cells, palisade cells and spongy cells. So palisade cells are elongated, spongy cells are oval. They are both, palisade and spongy cells are modified parenchyma cells. They contain chloroplast. This chloroplast contains a green pigment called chlorophyll. And these cells, because of this, they are green colored, right? So these are green colored parenchyma cells. Palisade cells are present on the upper side of the leaf. Spongy cells are present on the lower side of the leaf. Then the vascular bundles. So vascular bundles are located inside the veins, right? Vascular bundles are located inside the veins. Now the vein present in the center of the leaf, it is called midvein or midrib, right? So this midrib, it contains a large vascular bundle, whereas the side veins, they are small, so they contain small vascular bundles. So here we shall consider the structure of a single vascular bundle. So in the vascular bundle of dicot leaf, phloem is present on the lower surface, xylem is present above the phloem, right? So phloem is on the lower side, xylem is on the upper side. So such vascular bundle, it is called conjoined. It is called conjoined vascular bundle because phloem and xylem, they are present in the same bundle and they lie in the same radius. Then in the midrib region, below the epidermis, there is a small part called hypodermis, which consists of collenchyma cells. And these collenchyma cells, they provide mechanical support to the dicot leaf. So that is the anatomy of a dicot leaf. So you can expect a 5-mark question. Explain the anatomy of dicot leaf. So you have to explain this. Or you may expect a diagram. Draw a section of dicot leaf. So with this, we shall conclude this video. Thank you.